Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. It's Svelte's question time. You have any question? I have answers for you. So, the question for today is about what is a component initialization? What is component initialization? Sometimes when you look at a doc, you see something like this, where it says set context like life cycle function, this must be called during component initialization. And if you try to search for this in a few in the documentations, you see get context has to do this, has context, and on mounts, before mounts, all of them needs to be called during component initialization. So what is that? When is this component initialization happening? So, we're gonna find this out. So, when is this component initialization happening? Right? So if you take a look at the code example that I've prepared over here, I would say the rule of thumb when whether your code is executed during component initialization is that your code has to be at the top level of the script tag. Rule of thumb, on top level of the script tag. So here, import let name, this function, rule of thumb, they're kind of like being executed during component initialization. Right? Of course, it depends on optimization. They may be declared, for example, functions over here, they may declare ahead of time. Imports may happening ahead of time as well. Right, but for example, things like here, when you call on click like this, execute, this will be executed during component initialization. Right, so if you come over here and you do things like, say setting an on mount, right? If I come over here and call on mount over here, then you are good because this on click function is being called over here during component initialization, and therefore you are good to go because this should be called during component initialization, right? But of course you don't see this often. Most of the case you'll see that you write on mount over here at the top level, yeah, and they will be called during component initialization. And things like set context, on destroy, on mounts, all of them you have to call it over here, right? You can't really call it right, you have to call it over here. You can't really call it later on. So when do you mean by later on? It's like almost everything you write here is kind of like being executed immediately, right? Yeah, but in the script over here, most of there are two cases that are not really executed immediately. So one is reactive statements or declarations. So code over here, for example, if you do on mount over here, they are not actually, sometimes you realize that there's no error. It seems like it's good, but this is, I would say it's not recommended and it may not be safe, right? Because you on mount should be called during initialization so that it can register a callback function when when your component is mounted, right? But if you do it over here, and if you have some condition and then do this later on, then your on mount may be registered later on and it may not be happening during component initialization, right? So I mentioned on mounts and initialization. So there are actually two different things. First is your component will be initialized, set up, and then Svelte will go over to create all the elements you need, right? So for example, if you need to initialize things like states and functions, callback functions over here, on click functions and all this, is being initialized during component initialization phase. So then when you create the elements later on, for example, here I want to create a h1 tag with hello name, I have the value of this variable ready, right? So that I can create this element with this hello world because name is world. Then what happens is that once all these elements is being created, it'll be added to the DOM, right? Once everything is adding to, when you're adding, it's calling like a, it's called a mounting phase. But once everything is done, mounted on the DOM, your onMount function, the callback will be called, right? So that happens way after the component initialization phase, right? You initialize, set up all the variables and states, and then you create elements and things like that. And then you mount your elements onto the DOM, and then you'll have your onMount phase. Therefore, things happening inside onMount, on before update, on destroy, all of them are not, all these callback, the functions that you define inside are not happening during component initialization, right? Same thing goes with reactive statements. And second thing that is not considered as component initialization is in callback functions, right? So over here, onClick looks like it's good to go because you call this onClick on component initialization, and then you call this function over here. It is good in this aspect. But if your onClick function is being called somewhere else, like passing into a button onClick, which can be happens way later, or maybe you have an onMount over here, and you call onClick like this, then this is bad, right? This means that this function will be called later on after the component initialization phase. Then sometimes you get errors and warnings happening, right? So two things of no-no of component initialization is that reactive statements and declarations, most of the time you may see that it kind of like works, but it's actually not. Maybe sometimes there's no error, but it doesn't mean that you should do that or it works, right? And second place is the callback functions, right? All these callback functions happening way after, right? You have already initialized your component, you mounted your element, and then you click on the buttons that you just created, and then you trigger a callback. That is not component initialization anymore, right? That is like way after, it's like component updating or something like that, right? So there you go. So by understanding this, this means that onMount actually, because the example that I showed you just now, where you can call onMount inside some function, meaning that as long as your function is being called during component initialization, you can't actually extract this out and put it somewhere else, right? You can actually have a file called util and import onMount from Svelte, and then you can have initialize x component. Okay, maybe I was gonna say initialize button component. So all button component have this onMount logic. Then I can come over here and say onMount and register some function over here, and I can import this function inside my code. And use it directly, right? The key is that I have to call this function during component initialization so that this onMount is being called during component initialization, right? The key is you have to call it during component initialization. It does not have to be following the rule of thumb where it has to be declared on the top level. It just has to be called during there, that moment of time, right? So this unlocks some unlocks a lot of possibilities, because you can reuse this onMount logic in a lot of places, right? Because you can maybe say you create some sort of store over here and import writable, right? You create some sort of store and you onMount, and then you return the store that you created. Right, and over here, maybe you during onMount you try to register or listen to something, and then updates this store variable, or you do something like that. Right, there's a lot of possibilities as possible. Then you can, or maybe you have, and then you can share this function across a lot of components. You could also like have maybe like a singleton kind of thing, a store that is available for everywhere. And on every mount, you try to do something so that you can play around with different kind of design patterns. And actually, I've made a video about that. You know, I created this video called Ensemble Actions, where I share with you, if you have watched this, if not, you have to watch the video. So I shared where you can you can have a actions that can be applied to a lot of elements, a group of elements, and these groups of elements that apply to the same action works together to achieve one effect, right? It could be a drag and drop action where you have two actions, drag and drop, and they are created using one function, right? With that function, you create two actions, and actions apply to elements, and they work together seamlessly, right? And you can have this kind of actions to work with together with unmount and things like that. That there's a lot of things that you can play around over there aspect. So that's it about the component initialization. And before I end this video, I'm going to share you one trick how to know whether your code is actually called or run during component initialization, right? This is a trick. This is not a rule of thumb anymore. This is actually looking at the JavaScript output from your code. And if you scroll down all the way, you realize that there's this function called instance, right? So you can write some code and try around with this playground and switch to the JS output tab and take a look. All your components can be compiled and most of them will have this function called instance. Right, in this instance function, this function will only be called once. And as you can guess, this function will be called during component initialization. So things that are happening over here, when you call something, when you run something immediately right from here, it will be called during component initialization. Right. So if you call on click, initialize, onMount, setContext, onMount, declare something, all this will be called. Right, you just imagine running these functions and see that whether your onMount functions that require to be called during initialization, like onMount, onDestroy, setContext, getContext, hasContext, you check whether are they being called over here. If they are not, most likely, or it's definitely something is wrong, and you have to check. Most definitely, they are not being called or run during component initialization. Right, so if you take a look over here, if I have some, let me try to write something, just a quick one. So you try to write something like this, name, and on mount. Okay, I don't think I need this, I just write this. Name. Okay, I haven't imported this on mount, but by looking at this code, you roughly can see that this statement will be called every time when name changes, right? This is how reactive statement works, because it depends on, it will look at all the variables being used over here on mount, console, and name, and any of them change, if any of them changes, then this statement will be reevaluated, right? So this on mount actually happens and will be called every time when name changes, right? So if you take a look at the code and we verify this, you realize that this on mount happens inside a function that looks like this, right? This you shouldn't ponder too much about this. Scrutinize too much about this. This may change. It is something private, right? But just look at the code over here. You notice that instance function, right? You run this. You define this sets function, and you define this function, and you didn't call it, right? And then you return something immediately. So meaning your onMount is not being called during component initialization, and that is incorrect. You may not see any error happening, but that is not what we recommend, right? That may break sometime in the future, because it says that it must be called during component initialization. If it's not, then you may run into errors one day soon, Right, so that's all. That's my little trick for you. And I hope you learn something about component initialization. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And you have any more questions, comment down below. And you must have noticed that this is my Svelte question time, meaning I want more ideas for questions like this, right? For example, component initialization. You may not even realize that you can even learn so much from this question itself. So drop all your questions you have about Svelte, and I'll try to collect them and try to make a video out of it. And that's all. Subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next video is out. So see ya, bye bye.